Hello, this is Zachary, and I recently built a digital stopwatch using some integrated circuits that I bought online, and I just think it's really cool because this stopwatch does not operate on any programmable devices. There's no Arduinos or microcontrollers or anything like that. Everything is all hardwired with digital and analog circuits, so I'm gonna do a little demonstration and we'll see how it goes. We're gonna turn on the power and reset it. So the button on the left is the button to start the timer, and you have to hold it down for the timer to continuously count upwards. And when you release the button, the time will pause. And this button on the right, you press it to reset. So I'm gonna do a little demonstration. So it's counting upwards now. And I'm gonna hold this down for about a minute. And after a minute, you're gonna see that the second digit from the left increments upward, not when it reaches 99, but when the seconds reaches 59. And that's another little feature that I designed. Now, all of the digits are designed to increment when the one to the right hits 9. But for the minutes and seconds, you have to increment when it reaches 6. And the way I handled that was with this decade counter over here on the bottom. And this decade counter keeps track of when you reach 59 seconds and you go to 60 seconds, it will increase the number of minutes. But all the others will increment when the one to the right hits 9. All right, so there's a minute. Now I'm going to reset. Goes back to zero. So I'm going to briefly explain what each component of my circuit does. On this side, you have you have a 9-volt alkaline battery, and it powers a little voltage regulator over here, and that behaves as our power supply. You got a 555 timer over here, with a few resistors and caps, and that is behaving as our pulse generator. It generates periodic pulses 100 times per second. Then that gets hooked up to our start and stop button and our reset button. And over here, you have a decade counter, which, as I said before, counts up to 6 and resets the number of seconds and increments the number of minutes when it gets to 6. Well, 60 seconds, essentially. And on the middle row, we have 6 display drivers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Which you can see are hooked up to 6 7-segment LED displays, which makes sense that you have only one driver for a display, and that's how it is. One driver per display, which are connected to each other and to the decade counter and to the pulse generator. And so that's my circuit. I hope you enjoyed, and I plan to me to continue to make interesting digital circuits like this one in the near future. Thanks.